Yeah. Good morning to everybody. Bonjour tout le monde, and well, we'll begin our annual seminar, and I want to welcome all the members and colleagues, and especially students, because we are a former members association, but it's good to have a replacement.
Future.
As the future is listening to us. So, well, I would like to express my gratitude to the speakers who kindly accepted to participate in this seminar. First and foremost, we have Professor Danuta Hübner. She's currently the chairwoman of the Constitutional Affairs of the European Parliament. She was the first Polish commissioner in the...
So long ago,
yeah. Well, but this is for life. Yeah. And, well, she's a committed European, and she chairs in this moment this very important and prestigious committee of the Parliament. We have two to the left of Danuta. We have Professor Franklin de Hoos. He is a former judge of the European General Court, and currently, and before, he was a professor of international economic law at the University of Liège. So he has an interesting experience both in academy and as member of the court. And third is Paul Taylor. He's a contributor editor to Politico. Well, I'm not going to do a commercial, but Politico is one of the most alive press. Now you call is
new
media. Well, he has been for a long time the chief redactor of Reuters in Brussels. He's an old hand in this town and in the European Union. So I think it's very interesting to make this to mix up the justice, the press, and the politics. And well, we have invited two current MPs and two members of the relevant directorates of the a commission in the Parliament. The interpretation is available in English, French, German, Italian, and Spanish. And we decided to focus on what can be done to safeguard and promote democracy based on the founding principles of the Union. I think this is not a theoretical exercise. Yesterday evening I had the possibility and the honor to quote the message of Chancellor Merkel to President Trump when he was elected. And as you know, she expressed on behalf of the Große Koalition, but I think we can recognize ourselves in this, in her message, she expressed what the content of the Article 2 of the Treaty of Lisbon. And I quote, that this union is founded on the values of respect for human dignity, freedom, democracy, equality, the rule of law, and respect for human rights, including the rights of persons belonging to minorities. Well, as you know, this in Europe there have been a lot of constitutions and proclamations of these rights. But I think we can say that for the first time in our shared history, these values are enshrined in a treaty that is part of the constitution of all the member countries of the Union. And I think it's important to remember this in this moment when we are talking about, well, some aspects coming to the past to come back home and close the door, or we consider that we must throw all these values to the to the basket without taking into consideration. Moreover, as you know, there are some debates in not only in some countries of the Union, I think in the European Parliament and in the Commission regarding Article 7 of the Treaty. And this is related to enforcing the European Union values. And, well, there is an initiative of the Commission, and I think that Mrs. Hübner can better than me, and she follows this very closely. There's,
unfortunately,
I shared your view. The framework and to address systemic threats to the rule of law, and, well, there is a very interesting initiative adopted by the Parliament for the establishment of a new mechanism on democracy, rule of law, and fundamental rights. So I think it's very timely to have this debate in this moment. This is not part of an academic activity. I think this is well, political at the highest level of politics. And I want to thank our speakers, and I hope that we shall have a very alive debate. And, well, and I give the floor to Danuta Hübner. Thank you.
Thank you.